Hey, South Plains. This is Amanda with Lubbock Area United Way. We have really been working hard to bring you guys as much resources as we possibly can in the midst of the COVID-19 crisis. And one of those things that we wanted to start talking about and thinking about was how we can care for our little ones now that we are all home with little ones and trying to do work and trying to do school. And some of us have lost our jobs in the crisis or are waiting to hear what's going to happen with our job. That brings a lot of added stress. So we wanted to reach out and talk to one of our partners, Carla Olson, who is the director at the Parenting Cottage. She also happens to be the chair of the South Plains Coalition for Child Abuse Prevention. And yesterday, April 1st, kicked off National Child Abuse Prevention Month here in Lubbock. We do what we call Go Blue Lubbock to try to draw attention to the fact that there's 3 kids every day in Lubbock County that are confirmed abused or neglected. And we really have been working hard on that the last several years to bring that stat down and to bring our rates of child abuse down. So we felt like Carla would be a great person to talk to. So Carla, world has changed completely. Yeah, completely. You know, we were just before we started recording, we were just getting to talk to my son, my 3-year-old, who I'm home with, and trying to figure out how do I work and how do I parent, and you know, what do we do to help our kids cope and help ourselves cope and try to prevent ourselves from getting too stressed out in this scenario. What are some things that we can do as parents?
Well, I think the biggest challenge, Amanda, is that we've lost structure. We had structure in our lives before. Moms and dads knew what they were going to do in the morning. They were going to, you know, get up, get the kids ready for school or preschool, go to work. You know, there was after school activities. And so parents have kind of lost their structure, but more importantly, kids. And so when, especially children, we think children don't have structure. That is sometimes their frustration comes out when they act things out. They're unsure of what's going to come next. But parents are kind of getting in that boat too, a little bit. And, you know, when we started this, we might have thought, oh, it's a week or two or whatever. And now it could be longer. And we're finding out there's more challenges to this than we thought they were. So I would say to parents, you know, the first thing you can do is take a big old deep breath. Realize you're not in this alone. You're not the only frustrated parent out there. You're frustrated by external factors. But also, you know, you're trying to balance, I've got to do my job. I need to go in here and do a video conference. And I've got toddlers running around me. So, you know, maybe sit down with your family, especially if you have a partner and both of you are juggling these things, and kind of figure out a routine. Children respond very well to routines. When they know what's going to happen next, then they're calm. And we as adults are just children, larger children in bigger bodies. So if you can, whatever you can do to make your routine as normal as it can be, or repeat it, especially for young children. If you repeat for them the same thing every day, even if you're trying to work with them on schoolwork, they had a routine in school. So if they used to do math first thing in the morning, and now you're trying to do that at 6 o'clock at night, you're gonna get a little irritation and feedback. So sit down and talk to them about what was your routine in school? Even the younger ones, what did you do in preschool? And do what you can to replicate that.
That's great advice, Carla. You know, we have, not only do we have 3-year-old Jack, but we also have 15-year-old Caroline. And so that's quite the balance in our house. But we sat down as a family the other night and, you know, looked at her schedule, because of course this is the first week that she's doing online learning. So the schedule that the school had sent of what she was expected to do, and looked at my schedule. And my husband works for an essential service, so it's just the 3 of us here today. And Jack's going to come join us, I think, and play Play-Doh right next to us. So this is going to be fun. The new reality, right, parents? But then we sat down and we made a list of what are some mental health things that we can do. You know, if we feel ourselves starting to get stressed out, what's some simple things that we can do Like, could we go for a walk? Can we stop and have a family dance party? You know, what are some things that we can do to handle stress? So there comes a point. Yesterday, you know, talking about being out of routine and out of boundaries, Jack, you know, got to a point in the day where he decided he needed to put himself in timeout because that was the kind of day that we were having. So when parents get to that point where they feel like I need to put myself in timeout, what are ways that we and parents can keep from that explosion? Because there's a whole lot of new stress. And I really feel like sometimes you, as a parent, you think I would never do that. But in these stressful, high anxiety and unstable times, there, you kind of don't know what to expect from yourself. Yes. Yeah. So how can we help parents get to that explosive moment?
Don't feel guilty about getting to that moment. What's important is that what you do with that moment after you get there. You know, the one thing that we tell parents is that you will never outshout your children. So, you know, the more that you yell at your children, all you do is cause the agitation to go up for both you and the child. So, you know, the very first thing you can do is when we tell our kids to use their indoor voice, that's what we like to tell parents. Use your indoor voice. You know, first of all, if you want to get your child's attention, the very best thing you can do is call them by name. So call their name, you know, and then try and, you know, do what you can to explain the situation to them. They're still children. They still don't process information like you do. So, you know, I would say for everyone, try and include physical activity during the way to burn off energy, especially the older kids. So maybe you start your day off with that. Maybe you do it at lunchtime. Maybe you do it at the end. But again, if you've got that structure going for both of you, and built in that structure has to be some me time for those parents where you can go in there and take a bubble bath and for 15 minutes nobody says mom or, you know, whatever it is, but you need those mental health moments. But your kids do also.
That's great advice, Carla. So mental health moments, make sure we get in some physical activity to burn off some of that steam. And when we get to that point, don't try to outshout the kids. Use your inside voice and call them by name and try to calm the situation down. Great advice, Carla. So we are in Child Abuse Prevention Month. If people are concerned about their neighbors or about something that they're seeing, you know, our main reporters are our educators and our teachers. We're not making a big enough snake. Hang on. what do we need to do if we suspect something's going on?
Well, surprisingly, you know, when you actually look at the law in the state of Texas, it says everyone's responsible for reporting suspected child abuse and neglect. So it's not just our school reporters or, you know, professionals or whatever. So, you know, the one thing I say to lay people in the community is, you know, their biggest question is, well, I'm not sure if it's child abuse or neglect, or, you know, I saw this, but I'm not. You don't have to determine if it meets the legal requirement for child abuse and neglect. But if you've got that niggling little thought in the back of your mind of something doesn't look right, or these kids don't look like they're being taken care of, any person can call the child abuse hotline, which in Texas is 1-800-252-5400. If you think it's more an imminent harm that something's going to happen to that child, you know, within the next few hours or the next few minutes or whatever, that's when you want to contact law enforcement. So, but, you know, always report it if you suspect it. The Department of Family and Protective Services, they'll take your input and they'll be the ones to determine if it meets the legal measure for child abuse and neglect.
Perfect, Carla. Thank you so much. And we've got that hotline number on our website. Everybody say hi to Jack. Hi, Jack. We've got that number on our website. So if you in our resource center, and certainly you can go to Carla. Y'all's website is parentingcottage.org. Is that right? Okay. So get resources there. I want to thank everybody for sitting and listening. Carla, thanks for joining us today and giving us some parenting tips. We're hoping to come back with some more of these spots to just kind of help us all navigate our new reality and life with kids. Okay.
There you go.
Jack, can you tell everybody bye-bye?
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.